with the release of the NHD15G2, Noctua also introduced its new fan, the NF-G2. It might have a maximum speed similar to the Noctua NF-G1 that the NHD15G1 used, but it outperforms that fan in every aspect. Moreover, the new fan has normal dimensions, 140 by 140 millimeters, while the older model measures 140 by 150 millimeters. The noise output is slightly higher in the latest model, according to Noctua's measurements, 24.8 decibels versus 24.6 decibels, and the bearing remains the same SS02 type. A note, the NHD15G1 uses the NF-A15 high-speed version and not the plain one, which is restricted to 1200 RPM. Back to the G2 fan, Noctua states that it is a good upgrade for its existing coolers, and I second that, given that its performance is superior. The only problem is that at $40 per fan, you will need $80 to replace both fans on a previous generation Noctua cooler. Some could argue that you can get a very good air cooler or even a decent all-in-one with this amount of money. The fan has 9 blades and is made of Stirox liquid crystal polymer. I want to stay on some of the fan's most important features. Progressive bent impeller. The NF-G2 features a progressive bent impeller with flow acceleration channels and winglets. Its 9 blades are swept backward close to the hub and progressively bent forward further out. Working in tandem with centrifugal turbulator hub, this design not only helps to push more air toward the outer blade areas where efficiency is higher, but also ensures maximum lift and near uniform loading across the entire blade span. The new centrifugal turbulator hub design improves flow attachment in the hub region. At the same time, each centrifugal driving motion pushes air outwards from the hub area where efficiency is low due to the slow rotational speed towards the outer high efficiency zones of the blade, thereby increasing overall efficiency by optimizing fluid distribution across the impeller area. Flow acceleration channels. The NF-G2 impeller features suction side flow acceleration channels. By speeding up the airflow at the crucial outer blade regions, the measure reduces suction side flow separation, leading to better efficiency and lower vortex noise. Winglets. Winglets can help reduce tip vortices caused by the pressure differential between the suction and the pressure side of fan blades, but bear the risk of reducing efficiency due to the extra fluid displacement in high velocity regions. The NF-G2's small winglets have been fine-tuned to provide consistent efficiency gains working in tandem with its progressive bent blade geometry. Flow acceleration channels and AAO frame. The NF-G2 has a tight tip clearance, distance between the blade tips and the inside of the frame, of only 0.7 mm. This design helps the NF-G2 work more efficiently against back pressure, such as on heat sinks or radiators, by reducing leak flows through the gap between the impeller and the frame. Step inlet design. Noctua's step inlet design adds turbulence to the influx to facilitate the transition from laminar to turbulent flow. This reduces tonal intake noise, improves flow attachment, and increases suction capacity, especially in space-restricted environments. Inner surface microstructures. With the tips of the fan blades blowing through the boundary layer created by the inner surface microstructures, flow separation from the suction side of the blades is significantly suppressed, which results in reduced blade passing noise and improved airflow and pressure efficiency. According to the above, Noctua could easily shift from fan design to aviation propellers anytime. Test methodology. I use a fan performance measurement apparatus to evaluate cooling fans This is a highly sophisticated scientific instrument made in Taiwan by Longwin. Besides the Longwin machine, I also use a hem anechoic chamber and a highly sophisticated and super expensive noise analyzer by Pruill and Care. The fan's maximum speed is low, so I don't expect top maximum performance readings, but think about it. How many of you have your fans spinning at full speed? This is why I pay more attention to the normalized noise test. Despite its low speed, the G2 fan achieves a pretty high airflow and decent static pressure. Moreover, the difference between the previous generation Noctua fan and the one who spins at the same speed is vast. The power consumption is increased though. The fan's noise output is low. Frequency plots: 10% fan speed, peak frequency 4 kHz, 25% fan speed, peak frequency 4 kHz, 50% fan speed, peak frequency 315 Hz, 75% fan speed, peak frequency 500 Hz, 100% fan speed, peak frequency 630 Hz, second frequency 100 kHz, third frequency 250 Hz and 800 Hz. I have recorded the signals of these charts, but please keep in mind that I've enabled automatic gain control to make it easier for you to reproduce them. Normalized noise test, 20 decibels noise output, low speed, top airflow, top static pressure, high power consumption. 25 decibels noise output, low speed, top airflow, top static pressure, high power consumption. 30 decibels noise output, low speed, top airflow, top static pressure, high power consumption. Advertised versus real performance. In this table, anything in red means bad news, while the blue fonts are good. In my measurements, the maximum speed is a bit higher. The airflow is higher than the official specs, which is good, of course, and the static pressure is about the same. The noise output difference between the advertised and the value I measured is high. A note here about the power consumption numbers. So far, I noticed that most brands provide power consumption information without providing the precise fan operation. Whether it is operating at maximum airflow or maximum static pressure, or in a state in between. The fact is that when the fan is under load, meaning that it delivers its full static pressure, its power consumption increases. This is why, from now on, if there is no information on the fan's operating conditions, I will compare the advertised power consumption with the readings I have at 100% fan speed with an obstacle, maximum static pressure, and without obstacle, maximum airflow. In case there is a power consumption information stating the fan's operating condition, I will provide the corresponding results I got. It took Noctua some time, it actually took a long time to release a top performing fan, but the result is fantastic. The NF-G2 achieves top performance in the normalized noise test, which matter the most, and even in maximum numbers, it puts to shame fans spinning at much higher speeds and outputting way higher noise. The features and design details are numerous, and at some point I thought I was reading about an aviation part and not an IT one. Noctua's engineers did a hell of a job in the G2 fan, although I know that many of you will complain about its high price and some will also complain about the lack of HB lighting. I believe that its price tag isn't extreme given the development cost and its build quality. Yes, it is expensive, but you get top performance and top quality, and it will probably live forever if you don't have it operating under extreme conditions. You cannot expect top support, quality and performance at a budget price. If you find something like that, there will be always a catch, or the corresponding company will have other means of living and just creates products for fun. At 25 decibels normalized noise output, a noise level that won't annoy most users while allowing for high enough speeds for decent performance, the G2 fan achieves top airflow. Its static pressure is also high, losing only to the Arctic P14 Max, which is notably more affordable. To check all alternative fan offerings, read my best cooling fans article on hwbusters.com before investing in new cooling solutions. You can also find this review on hwbusters.com. That's all. Bye-bye.